Welcome to my YouTube channel, Social Credit. I am Prashant Kumar. We are discussing about the 10th standard social science today. Social and religious reformation movements. Reformation, already formed, but ruined or destroyed. That's why we have to reform it. Bring back such a society into the fold of human values. So that is the reformation. And the 19th century is considered as the reformation and a new awakening time in the history of India. And actually here, British provided English education. They implemented English education in India. As a result, a new class of educated Indians were created. And so these new class of educated Indians, they studied the concepts, the Western concepts or European concepts of democracy, nationalism, equality. So because of this, what happened in their mind? What were the drawbacks in our society? They found that. They compared Eastern and Western thoughts and they realized how important our values are, our scriptures, etc. In the eyes of Western, they studied the Indian culture. And not only this much, British also thought that it is their duty to improve the Indians. They believed that it is their duty to civilize the Indians. That's why they told white man's burden. So, in the Indian society, there were many problems like caste system, gender discrimination, sati system, and widow remarriage restrictions, denial of education to Shudras and other classes. So like this, many problems were there. To root out these problems and rebuild this society, social and religious reformation movement started. So in this moment, we have to discuss something that is some people, those who started this one. In that, the first person and the father of Renaissance, our father of this national movement, he was Raja Ram Mohan Roy. Raja Ram Mohan Roy, he is the chief initiator of social reformation movement in India. And he studied different languages like Sanskrit, Persian, Arabic, and studied the literature in that language. And he was well versed in Hindu philosophical critic and Quran also. Apart from this, he studied other religions which are found in India critically. And he studied Hebrew and Greek to read Bible in its original form. Because if it is translated to other languages, then what happens? So their view comes there. That's the original form he wanted to study. So about Brahma Samaj or Raja Ram Mohan Roy, we have to study. So Ram Mohan Roy, he started Atmiya Sabha in Calcutta. This Atmiya Sabha aimed at eradicating socio-religious maladies from the society of Bengal. That's why they are discussing with his friends. He started that one. Their discussions will be conducted between them, and they wanted to solve that. And this person, Ram Mohan Roy, he had contact with the British officers with the help of, because of the effort of Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Governor General William Bentinck brought the law prohibiting sati system in 1829. And Raja Ram Mohan Roy published a journal, Samvad Kaumudi. It was a journal. Okay. And actually, Samvad Kaumudi is the first journal, first newspaper published by an Indian. Okay. And he advocated monotheism, main principles of main important aspects of Brahma Samaj, if you want to say. It advocated monotheism. Only one God, polytheism, more than one god. Monotheism, we should not quarrel for the god. Opposed meaningless rituals, many meaningless rituals he opposed that. And every person should live with dignity, and no law or ritual should violate this provision. They have their own dignity, should not be destroyed. Opposed polygamy, having more than one wife, polygamy he opposed. And opposed child marriage, and he opposed the sati system. And he declared that one can take good things from anywhere. We should not close our mind. Open-mindedness necessary. If it is good, from anywhere you can take. It's very important one. He gave importance to English education. Yes, these are the main important aspects of Brahma Samaj. And Raja Ram Mohan Roy, he wanted the Indians to welcome the thinking process of the Europeans. And he supported to establish many schools and Vedanta College in Calcutta. That's why Raja Ram Mohan Roy was called as, say, Rabindranath Tagore, the great poet. He called Ram Mohan Roy as the harbinger of modern India, progenitor of Indian social reformation movement, and the prophet of Indian nationalism. See how nicely he called. By this we can understand his work. So this is about Raja Ram Mohan Roy. Next, another movement, the modernization started moving across the North India at that time. It was centered, this movement centered at Calcutta. In that movement, one Young Bengal movement. So this Young Bengal movement was started by Henry Louis Vivian Derazio. This Derazio, his father was a Portuguese, the mother Indian, that's why Anglo-Indian. And he served as a professor at Hindu College of Calcutta. And nearly 5 years he worked there. And many students attracted by his teachings. And they became his followers. His ideals, he spread his ideals through the students. They influenced by him. Derazio served as a professor in the Hindu College at Calcutta. And he worked for creating textbooks to inculcate the new education system. Actually, it is possible to bring changes through the children. It is possible to mold them. And from there, through education, it is possible to bring changes in the society. Started academic association, a free thinking debate association, where anyone can come and they can think freely, no restrictions there. And there held discussions and debates on issues like nature, humanism, God, and other topics. And he spread the message that only rational thinking would liberate people from the clutches of superstitions and social discrimination. See, only rational thinking, it is necessary only because of that it is possible to liberate the people from these clutches. And he supported rights, women rights or rights of women, and opposed caste-based discrimination. So most of the people, social religious reformers, they did that one. And many of his students who had come from traditional families, they followed him. As a result, what happened, he was forced to resign to the teaching post by his colleagues and his opponents. Because they thought, the young minds, they're getting morally corrupted by the thinking and the work of Derazio. And he died at his young age of 22 years due to cholera. So this is about Young Bengal movement. Next, we have to study another one, Arya Samaj, Swami Dayananda Saraswati. Swami Dayananda Saraswati was born in Kathiawad of Gujarat. His name was Moolashankar. His father, Amba Shankar Tiwari, and mother, Amrita Bai. And he had no interest in English. That's why he studied Sanskrit. He left his house by the age of 21 years and roamed across the country for 15 years. Kosha Odinodu Desha Sutinodu. So that's why he traveled throughout India for 15 years. And after studying the people and society, he outlined his ideas in a book titled Satyartha Prakasha. And he told, he gave a call, go back to Vedas. The reality is there in the Vedas actually. In the original Vedas, reality is there. Truth is there, but we are twisting that one. It will, he told. And in Arya Samaj, it was having some aims. What are the aims of Arya Samaj? All Hindus should believe in one formless God. Actually, it is saying like it only. The Vedas saying the same, but we believe in different way. Actually, God is having no shape, no color, no order. It's like water. In which vessel, if you keep that shape, it will get. Which shape we have, our mind is, which shape, that shape God will come. So actually, God is formless. Only one God. He told that one. No one is Shudra or Brahmin by birth and rejected caste system. Janmane jayate jantu, karmane jayate dvijaha. Because of his attitude, because of his nature, whether he is a Brahmin, Kshatriya, etc. decided. Not because of his birth, he told so nicely. Encouraged intercaste marriage. So broad thinking it is. Human being, full one caste now. No different castes here. Rejected polygamy and child marriage. Bad practices. And he told men and women are equal. In those days he told how nicely it is. One should study Vedas and other ancient sacred texts and preach them, he told. Everyone should study Veda. And he, these are the main aims of this Arya Samaj. And here, a new movement he started is a Shuddhi movement. Shuddhi movement means what? This Shuddhi movement aimed at reconversion of people who had converted to Islam and Christianity. Reconversion of them to the Hinduism back. Someone they wanted to come back by force, they were converted to that religion. If anyone wanted to come back, problem. The Hinduism is having that problem. It is not taking from other religion, people from other religion. If they wanted to convert, which religion they are, sorry, which caste they are, that question comes. So this Arya Samaj doing that work, converting, reconversion of the people, those who converted to other religion. And he started Cow Protection Association also. So Indian cows having its good values. Very precious. That's why to protect the cows, he started the association. And to provide education, he started Dayananda Anglo-Vedic College. And started Gurukula Vidyalaya at Haridwara. Actually, Lala Lajapat Rai, a freedom fighter who was influenced by the principles of Arya Samaj. Okay, this is about Arya Samaj. And Swami Dayananda Saraswati. Next, another one, Prarthana Samaj. The influence of Brahma Samaj reached to the regions beyond Bengal. And here, this Prarthana Samaj, which was started by Atmarama Panduranga at Bombay. In the beginning, everything in the Bengal region, now it changed. Towards that and Bombay, it reached up to Bombay. This Prarthana Samaj aimed at finding solutions to various problems of women and lower caste groups. Many problems the women have and also lower caste groups. It wanted to, this Samaj wanted to solve that problem and argued for the reinterpretation of Hinduism in the light of modern Western thinking. And I told, in the eyes of Western thinking, Western knowledge, we have to look at Indian knowledge or Hinduism. Then we can understand what is reality. Actually, we are wearing colored glasses, colored spectacles. So we can't see the real color of the nature. That's why we have to remove that. Reformation should be implemented in reality. It is not a show. It should be in reality and work for the education of women and rehabilitation of poor. And the followers of this Atmarama Panduranga or Prarthana Samaj, M.G. Ranade, Mahadev Govinda Ranade, R.G. Bandarkar, N.G. Chandravarkar, they were the prominent leaders here. And this Prarthana Samaj opposed child marriage and supported widow remarriage. And commonly, all the Samaj, if the question comes, what are the principles of Samaj, what are the works of so Raja Ram Mohan Roy, right, maybe, or Arya Samaj, Dayanand Saraswati, or Atmarama Panduranga, whoever may be, the common points are there. They opposed caste system, they opposed child marriage, they opposed polygamy, they opposed sati system, and they supported widow remarriage, they supported intercaste marriage. So all these things common points. Okay, so this is about Atmarama Panduranga or Prarthana Samaj. Next, Satyashodhak Samaj. And there were widespread discrimination based on caste and gender in Maharashtra, like other places also. So that's why Satyashodhak Samaj, started by Jyotiba Phule, aimed at providing equal rights to non-Brahmin class and women. They were suppressed class actually. And his ideas, his philosophy, he showed in his book. He wrote a book, Gulamagiri, and Shektarayach Asud, means cultivator's whip cord. And he opened schools for Shudras and girls. They were rejected. They were kept out of schools. That's why. And belonged to Mali caste. He allowed people from all castes to draw water from his well. In those days, Shudras were not allowed to take water from the well. But he allowed from his well. With Savitri Bai Phule, he established a hostel for girls, first women teacher Savitri Bai Phule. With Savitri Bai Phule, he established a hostel for girls, started school for girls. He worked in the direction of establishing society based on equality, no discrimination based on caste, color, creed or sex. That was the main principle of Jyotiba Phule or Satyashodhak Samaj. Next, we have to move to Aligarh Reformation Movement, or Aligarh Movement, started by Sir Syed Ahmad Khan. Actually, the anti-British sentiments were strong in the Muslim community. That's why they don't want to study English. As a result, they stayed away from the English education, resulted the missing of many opportunities that were based on English education. Sir Syed Ahmad Khan started a new movement, Aligarh Reformation Movement, to provide or educate the Muslims. Mohammedan Liberty Society was established to discuss on the issues like religion, social and political issues. And he declared that Quran is the authoritative book and other works on Islam are derived ones, derived from Quran. And he told, one has to interpret one's religion according to the changing times. So whatever it was, like that only we should not say. With the changing times, we have to interpret that. Otherwise, religion becomes sluggish, waste. So that one he told. And he fought against traditions, superstitions, ignorance, and irrationalities throughout his life, which found in the Islamic society. And said that without an open mind, any social or intellectual development is impossible. If we are narrow-minded, it is not possible. We should have open-mindedness. We have to accept good thing from everywhere. That one Raja Ram Mohan Rai told. Yeah. And he did not support the parda system for Muslim women. And that is a blind belief, there is a bad practice, he told. He opposed that. And he called for educating Muslim girls. Muslim girls were kept inside the house, they should not come out. But nowadays, see, many Muslim girls, they are coming to school. They are educated. So he supported that. Girls should also come forward to get education. And he did not accept polygamy. Because of polygamy, the girls' feelings will be suppressed. That's why. Now in the educated families, we can't see that polygamy. So that's why he thought. He told education only, the one solution to solve all the problems, that is education. In order to implement his ideals into practice, he founded the Mohammedan Anglo-Oriental College in Aligarh. So again, I want to say the same thing. Only through education it is possible to bring changes in the society. And he thrived for unity among the Hindus and Muslims. He wanted to bring unity. And he worked for the fusion of Eastern and Western thoughts. So these are the main principles of Aligarh movement, Aligarh reformation movement of Sir Syed Ahmad Khan. Yes, next. Ramakrishna Mission. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa was a priest in the Kali temple at Calcutta. And Vivekananda was his disciple. Swami Vivekananda, he founded Ramakrishna Mission to propagate the thoughts of his spiritual guru, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. And he founded this Ramakrishna Mission at Belur near Calcutta. Not Hassan Belur, it is near Calcutta. It is in 1897. And Ramakrishna Mutt was established at Mayavati near Almora of Uttaranchal. And Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, he told, one has to attain moksha through dhyana and bhakti. Seven chakras are there, we have to awaken these chakras, etc., he told. And he told, I saw the God. And here Swami Vivekananda, he wanted to spread the spiritual ideas or provide thoughts of my spiritual guru, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. And Vivekananda was born in the Kasta family in Calcutta, and he studied both Western and Eastern thoughts. Then you can compare that. He preached the importance of Indian philosophy after going through it in detail to the Indians and the Westerners. The importance of Indian philosophy. He studied Indian philosophy and Western philosophy. Eastern and Western both he studied. And finally he understood Indian philosophy is superior one. And he preached the importance of Indian philosophy. Not only to the Indians but also to the Westerners. Worked to establish a casteless society again. Every society, every mission, every samaj worked towards that side. Wanted to eradicate the exploitation, poverty, illiteracy and class division in Indian society. He believed that people should be educated before seeking reformation. Again, I want to stress that one, education. Whatever reformation you want to bring, whatever change you want to bring, first you have to educate the people. Don't make literate, educate them. Literate and educate different. and wanted legal institution to implement appropriate rules to support reformation. Only oral saying no is not enough. Legal institution necessary to implement appropriate rules to support reformation. And wanted people to stop following Western ideals blindly, what we do the same thing. Blindly, we should not follow the Western ideals. Our ideals are very nice. Hittalagidamadala. We are not following that. Western ideals. So that is bad actually. Our yoga, how nice it is. Our Vedas, Upanishads, how nice it is. Actually, our mantra in Purusha Sukta, they explained about the generation of energy without fuel. Electricity generating. How to do, what to do, everything explained. One engineer wanted to explain that. NASA scientists, engineers, they came and they surprised actually. Now in Gujarat, they are starting that one. The government supported. With the support of the government, they are starting that. Yes. And he believed it is the duty of the religion to provide light. What is the duty of religion? Religion should not divide the society. Religion should not destroy the society. And religion should not corrupt the minds of the people. It should provide light. Without providing light, a religion is itself. Religion itself is of no use at all. Religion is no use. Religion means it should throw light. It should bring people from darkness to light. Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya, that is necessary. He wrote books on Jnana Yoga, Raja Yoga, Karma Yoga and Bhakti Yoga, four yogas. And he told, one who responds to the poor is Mahatma, and one who doesn't is a Duratma. Actually, his words are so nice. How real it is. And he told, we should take the humanity to such a place where there is no Quran, no Vedas and no Bible. Still, we need to attain this by attaining unity among Quran, Vedas and Bible. How nice it is. Actually, in our country, there is a need for unity between Hindus and Islam. The Vedic mind in Islamic body is the only path of progress. We should unite together. That one he told so nicely. Swami Vivekananda, a great personality actually. And he attended World Religious Congress in 1893. He became very famous while going an ordinary saint. While coming, he became world famous. In the Congress of Religion in Paris also he participated. But in Chicago, why he became very famous? That world, Americans, etc., they are talking ladies and gentlemen. But when he started, my brothers and sisters, it's not so easy. Universal brotherhood. But to say others as brothers and sisters, that he showed, there itself he showed, there is an Indian culture. And before his visit to Chicago, he met Chamarajendra, Chamaraja Vadayar 10th. And because of his effort, because of his influence, Chamaraja Vadayar 10th started school for untouchable children. So there is a greatness of Swami Vivekananda. To say Swami Vivekananda, ours together necessary, that's why. So this is the main thing he told. Yoga and prayer is very important to develop human mind actually. So this is about Ramakrishna mission. Next, Theosophical Society. This society was founded by common mistake the students will do here. Theosophical Society means immediately they will say, who was the founder? Anivasant. No. Theosophical Society was founded by Madame Blavatsky and Colonel H.S. Alcott. Okay. And Russian lady Madame Blavatsky and American gentleman Colonel H.S. Alcott. This society was established at Dyar near Madras in 1886. And this society aimed to perform a comparative study of various religions, philosophies and science. Its another goal was to discover the indomitable spirit hidden in the human being. There's a great spirit is there within us. Great power is there within us. We have to discover that. We have to bring it out. It is another goal. Declared that universal brotherhood is important. It took its basic principles from Hindu scriptures like Veda, Upanishads, Sankhya Yoga and Vedanta philosophy. And society attempted to find solutions to present problems by studying the ancient Indian thoughts, philosophies and theoretical ideals. See, problem solutions are there in our society. Ancient literature, ancient thoughts, problem we have, solutions also there within us. We have to find it, we have to open our eyes and we have to see. For us, others should show. So now, Annie Besant also there in the Theosophical Society. And actually, why Annie Besant? Commonly we say the name of Annie Besant with the Theosophical Society. This Irish lady Annie Besant, with her arrival, the movement got dynamic form. That's why we call her as the founder actually. Many people they say like that. She advocated that Indian culture is far more superior to the Western culture. See, others should say our culture is good. Translated Bhagavad Gita to English. As a result, she got the title Shweta Saraswati. She was white, no, that's why. And opened schools. We don't want Bhagavad Gita, but they want, see. She opened schools and started Central Hindu schools and started Central Hindu Benaras College. Some schools she opened. And started periodicals. So New India, Commonwealth and Young India are the periodicals started by her. And also she started a Home Rule League in Madras. Maharashtra, Pune, Balagangadhar Tilak started, but here she started in Madras Home Rule League, Home Rule Movement. And she was the first woman president of Indian National Congress. She served our country in the national movement also, in the freedom movement also. She was the first woman president of Indian National Congress. Okay, this is about Annie Besant and Theosophical Society. Next, we have discussed about Sri Narayana Dharma Paripalana Yogam. Narayana Guru started this one. This aimed at strengthening the backward and exploited. Especially in Kerala, this was started. One caste, one religion and one God was the basic idea. So all are saying the same. Only one caste, human being. One religion, human religion. One God, whatever it may be. Formless, shapeless or formless, colorless, orderless. One God. One superpower, only that much we have to think. Declared education is the only path to achieve this. Again, education. Built temples for the backward communities. They were not allowed. And started Vaikam movement, the place name Vaikam. Vaikam movement, a temple entry movement. Actually, in Guruvayur, etc., they started this movement, temple entry movement. So, this is the main theory of Narayana Guru. Next. A self-respect movement started by E.V. Ramaswamy Naikar. Ramaswamy Naikar is very famous as a Periyar. And this self-respect movement is a non-Brahmin movement. Non-Brahmins, they started this movement, started self-respect league in 1926. And he started a new movement based on Dravida racial identity. And he supported the Dravidas, South Indians Dravidas. And he participated in the Vaikam movement. Narayana Guru started Vaikam movement. There he participated. And he rejected the racial supremacy in the name of Arya or Arya and Brahmin. Aryan race is good, etc. Someone say, no? And he opposed that. Opposed the Sanskrit language and literature. So why, I don't know. Sanskrit language. See, because of the problems of few people, those who twisted, we should not hate the religion, the language itself, literature itself. In the literature, many good things are there. What literature did, human being is doing. Anyway, his idea. But another great thing is here. He rejected Rama as the Vedic leader. He accepted Ravana as the Dravidian leader. Ravana, great person, no doubt in it. Only one mistake he did, he kidnapped Sita. Great devotee, he improved so much, Ceylon was improved. So great personality actually. And after kidnapping Sita, so he didn't touch Sita. Without her permission, he didn't touch her. So greatness is there, no doubt in it. Okay, anyway, his ideals, these are. Criticized caste and gender-based discrimination, definitely we have proposed. Started an association called Dravida Kalagam. In Tamil Nadu, we can see DMK, Dravida Munnetra Kalagam. So that Dravida Kalagam started by him and became the president of Justice Party and started Justice Periodicals. So he became famous as Periyar there. Yes. The ideology of non-Brahmical movement started by Ayantidas and T.M. Nair was turned into cultural movement by this person, Periyar. So his life goal was to establish equal society where there will be no inequality based on caste, religion or gender. It was his idea. So this is about Periyar and all the religious and social and religious reformers. So totally saying we should be educated. We have to think properly. We have to read. We have to understand the reality. Simply blindly we should not follow anything. Then definitely it is possible to bring changes. So this is about reformation. Thank you. Thank you very much.